Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon for the Commodore Amiga. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Forgot something. I wanted to identify this last set of sandals. I'm sure it's nothing, but... I was right, it's nothing. Whee! Alright, we're going back to the village. Back to the village! Again. It's an Iron Maiden song. Not this song, you know. What I just did. Village is 22133. It's like this way. Ugh. Put all that crap there. This is an awesome song. 22. Straight this way. They can't fly over the village and then drop down. I was gonna try to do that. Oh, it doesn't matter if we're... I figured if we were in the craft, we wouldn't get attacked. But alas, we be attacked. So I wonder if someone in the village can fix this harp, or if I have to go back to the guy I bought it from. I think he's an alien, that guy. We bought the harp from. We'll see if this guy here can fix it. But here, in this town, is where our ship's being kept, so... We'll most probably be going back to Ilion. Oh, he woke up. Alden, level 41, no new life points, 255 power points, 103 spell learning points, and 240 training points. Alright. So, tavern, smithy, prison, foodstuffs, merchant... I guess it's the smithy that we want. Let me just heal people up here. I'm running a little slow here. Going to save. In case anything happens, we don't have to go all the way through here again. Travel through and fight the sand lizard again. You want me to repair something? Alright, so it's Sabine who has it. The elf string. Okay. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Alright. What about the strings? Nope. Alright. Not broke, don't fix it. He can't fix it. So. Stands to reason that if we go back to Lyramion, they can't fix it there either, so I think I have to bring it back to the harp guy. Oh, really? We need light for the hangar? Well, that's fine. Still bumping into stuff. In our Meranian disguise. Awesome. Oh, it's like Airship Morag is a separate place. That's why the thing gets unmapped or something. It don't matter. We just need to go back to Lyramion. I think we used the yellow navstone for that. Just not sure. Okay, that would be Morag. It's going by the number of letters in the word. The Ram. That would be Lyramion. Lyramony. I guess. Yellow navstone. Blue navstone. Okay. I've read that before, so. It says that even if you're not going to Lyramion, but luckily this time we are going to Lyramion. So it's the blue navstone. Exciting, guys. We finished the Morag Moon and the Forest Moon, as far as I know, unless something comes up and we have to go back. Hangar on Lyramion, okay. Oops. Pretty sure it's south. Okay, that's right. This is where we need to break. Where we need to use the harp. Can't wait. Oops. I just realized I've been playing this for over 2 years. As I'm playing this, though, it's been a year. So it's May right now, but you guys aren't going to see this until July or something like that. But yeah, because I only put up 2 episodes a week, which would be normally anywhere between 30 and 41, 42 minutes or something. So when you do that, it takes this long. But so we need to go to Ilion. I want to just rest anyway, because we need a little bit. We need to see and stuff. So you need one. He's got none and he needs one. We got zero, zero, and a bunch. 34, 55. Can anyone take 32? You know, Walden, but that's not gonna help us. Can I take 54? Doubt it. Okay. Oh god. We just flew through space. I want to wake up in the morning. Okay, good. Eagle flute. Okay. So let's see where we have to go. It's been a while since I looked at this map. We are here. And we need to go here, I think? Yes. Alright. So, northwest-ish. Definitely more north than west. I think we can fly over that. Oh, we can. We're still, yeah, on this continent. Or island, whatever. This is the Ilian continent? Out, says the eagle. Well, I don't miss this song. We'll try to get going. Music Master! Where is the Music Master? I think it's interesting how he has all these, like, parrots and stuff, because they're songbirds, so... Well, all birds are songbirds. Well, almost all. You see a young elf. He is wearing a robe stitched with gold notes and is holding a beautiful elf harp in his hands. Well, we have that too. I guess Sabine can talk to him because she has the stuff. Oh, I love this. The master looks at you with a penetrating glance and raises his harp. Magical music then fills the room. Like this. I love it. Elf harps are the most beautiful instruments on Lyramion. They almost play themselves. Perhaps you are interested in a harp? I will sell you one for 10,000 pieces of gold. I think it was 5,000 we got it from. But then again, I have more charisma and it's Sabine talking. That might seem expensive, but remember, you cannot get an instrument like it anywhere else. I think we just need to give him the stuff. Strings. Just want to see if he might say anything. Crystal string. No, all right. I think I just give this to him. Give him both of them. I'm just gonna say first. The master looks at you with sadness in his eyes and lowers his harp. The end of the music leaves an emptiness in the room. That may make you sad. I just want to save the game. K. game? What game? You think life is but a game? Yay, he's happy again. Alright, so Sabine, you must give things. This item does not interest me. Well then try the strings. Matthias takes the strings and the elf harp and begins to fit the strings. Shortly afterwards, he says, "Well, there you are. But I must warn you, the music played on the harp is now deadly. If you use it in battle, you will destroy most of your opponents. But you yourselves are completely safe from its destructive magic." That's interesting. Crystal harp. Alright, Sabine can take that back. Thank you. Still trying to sell us the harp. Alright. Bye. Don't be sad. You can play your music without me in here. Just a brief visit. We really must be going. Alright, so now we're going back down south east-ish. Oh, this is it. You can't dismount here. But I wanted to land on the roof. Alright, so this is where we need to do our thing. I don't know if it need to be a certain amount close to it or anything. Exciting, guys. So exciting. My gold. Alright. Magical item. Well, you know what? Hold on a second. We need to identify this. Voldemort needs to identify the harp. So Nelvin could wield this, or Sabine. Dissolve victim. 5 charges. That's cool. Does it have any other properties? Like, I don't think it does. There's no things here. Okay. Now what if... what if we try to use it here, like... just curious. You're in the wrong place to use this item. Citrine lets her fingers glide over the strings of the harp, and a heavenly sound reverberates through the hall. Citrine plays faster and louder, systematically playing in different keys as she almost reaches the lower strings. A gentle tremble passes through the temple, and the crystal wall begins to crack. Citrine plays more loudly, and the wall suddenly bursts into myriads of tiny shards. Don't know why they're assuming Citrine is a male character. character, and Citrine can't even use the harp. It's not... her class can't even use it, and she's not holding it, so that's, this whole thing is weird. But otherwise, pretty cool. Alright, down we go. Yeah, I'm saving again. There's a lot of spaces here that seem warranted. Oh, before, I don't know what we're gonna come across, so we need to get this stuff up. Barrier. Attack. And anti-magic. Sphere. Need to keep doing this, but this is the proper place to save. Down we go. We are seen. These, I guess these people or these monsters can see in the dark. Lantern used up. Oh, hi! Didn't miss you guys, that's for sure. Well, at least if someone gets killed, we can easily leave here and come back. Sleep on this guy. Because these two start to advance, and then I'll put one of them to sleep. Otherwise, yeah. I did not miss them. I'll leave this battle in since you guys haven't seen me fight them for a while. You always skip ahead on the video. You don't want to deal with it. Wouldn't blame you. Alright, so that guy's asleep. Except now we're waking him up, probably. Maybe. No damage. 5 damage. 21 damage. Alright. Small healing. Try to keep him up as much as possible. In case they get that critical hit, they might survive. We do take them down a little quicker now. Now that Edgel has that second... I mean that, well, 7th attack. And the magical attack buff really helps as well. Get the damage up. Like 40 points he would normally do otherwise. Yeah, he's already killed that one. So this guy in the middle is still asleep. But the other two are awake. I'll put that one to sleep. I'm focusing on that. .373. .36. Dead. Nice. Hmm. failing. I like that. I put sleep on this guy. Edgel's the only one needs to be healed, huh? Sleeping as much as possible. Oh, I deflected it. Damage 20 and 27. All right. Agile joins the battle. Medium healing for Citrine. I wonder if we can rest in this place. Try to put him to sleep again. Really just doing that in case someone's sword breaks. I mean, I think... Well, we have an extra Swift Stabbers, but I don't think we have an extra Morag sword or crossbow. Morag darts we have plenty of. So really, just in case this or this weapon breaks. Because we're gonna need that. And I'm not leaving here just to buy more equipment. We're ready to save the world here. Deflected again. I do not encourage such behavior. I'm dead. Morag dragons? What are they doing here? This is not Morag. I know. The people behind all this. Excuse me. Brought them here to guard their machine. I think that's what we're going down to destroy, right? Kill dragons on sight. The one in the back is asleep. Fire pillar. Oof. 63, 57. 41, 46, 57. Ouch. Another. Man, you're gonna kill Melvin. Melvin deflected. Good. Sabine deflected. Selena deflected. Citrine deflected. Okay, got Valden. The only one hurt was Valden. That's interesting. And he's not that much hurt. But Melvin needs some help. And I'm gonna mess around. Medium healing. Mm-hmm. put this guy to sleep. He's causing trouble. They're all causing trouble. Oof, all in 41. He's at 234. Selena's unharmed. Selena needs to heal herself, though, so she can continue to help others. I'm gonna try to put this last guy to sleep so we can attack him with impunity. Well, us in the back row are completely fine. Medium healing for Balden. This thing is probably almost defeated now. I think it's a small healing for Citrine. Okay. Nice and peaceful with these things sleeping away. I'm gonna bother moving over because I'm gonna attack this last one. Sleep. Kill. So the only one to hurt is Edgel. Let's see if a small healing would work for him. Edgel's gonna wrap this up pretty quickly. And this thing will probably die in the next round. So we've healed everybody. It remains, wow. For all we know, it has one hit point left or something. More than one, seven? There you go. Okay, guys, kill it! look mad now. So Bean kicking butt. Look at that. 20 and then 18 damage. That's a lot for her. These things really don't resist sleep at all. Neither do the Morag bosses. I'm leaving the gold. Oh, here we go. Same three. I'm gonna speed up this fight because it's gonna be just like the other one. Okay, Nelvin level 49. It's almost as high as Nelvin can get. 200 life points. I don't remember him being at 200 life points. Maybe they are going up, and they're just maximum goes up with it. Maximum and current go up with it, but I'm not sure. Anyway, 765 power points as well, 274 spell learning points, and 155 training points. Leaving the gold. Is that another monster back there? Well, we didn't come that far. Let's see the map. We can look at maps again. Yay! Machine room. Let's save. Made it this far. Oh, what the hell? Is that the machine? Guessing it's a machine that doesn't move. Before you stands a strange, large machine. Magic lights and auras flicker and radiate all around it. So is this thing actually alive? As you approach the machine, it suddenly springs to life. With a deafening, howling, and grinding noise, it attacks you.